ورحمة الله وبركاته. ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. Dear Muslims, Alhamdulillah, yesterday by the grace and favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we received the first day of the month of Dhul-Hijjah. And actually the month of Dhul-Hijjah is a very blessed month, being one of al-ashhur al-hurum, one of the sacred months, being the month during which the Hajj is performed, and also being the month of which the first 10 days and nights are of a very special rank and status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, in the Noble Quran, in Surah Al-Fajr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by the first 10 nights of the Hijjah, which is indicative of their great importance and benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. By the dawn, by the 10 nights, which are the first 10 nights of this current lunar month of Dhul Hijjah, وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ, and the Shaf', the even, is the 10th day of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Al-Nahr, or the day of Eid Al-Adha, and Al-Watr is the 9th day of Dhul Hijjah, which is the day of Arafah. So, these first 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah are so virtuous and distinguished in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told about the great importance and the high status of the first days, of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله منه في هذه الأيام العشر, أي العشر الأول من ذي الحجة. قيل ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, there are no days during which the good deeds are more pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these first 10 days of the Hijjah. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, even striving the aggressive and oppressive enemy for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that offering good deeds during the first 10 days of the Hijjah is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than striving against the oppressive and aggressive enemy for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, even striving the aggressive and the oppressive enemy for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except in a case that one goes forth with his life and wealth and he comes, does not come back with any one of them. So from this hadith, we know that offering good deeds during the first 10 days of the Hijjah is more beloved and pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than good deeds offered at any other time. And it is out of the great mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the great rewards of the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah are not only to be sought by the pilgrims. These great rewards of the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah are not only for the Hujjaj, for the pilgrims who go to make Hajj or who are now going to make Hajj. But these huge rewards are to be sought by all Muslims all over the world, both those who are going for Hajj this year and also with regard to all Muslims all over the world. Now, the question is, what should be our practice during these first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah? Firstly, we have to abandon all sins during the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah. Because though committing sins is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if they are done at any time, but a sin which is committed during the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah or during any time of the month of the Hijjah is worse and graver, because the month of the Hijjah is one of the sacred months, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the noble Quran imposes a specific prohibition and warns us especially against committing sins during the sacred months. So in the noble Quran, in Surah At-Tawbah, Surah number 9, verse number 36, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Al-Ashhur Al-Hurum, the sacred months, and what are the sacred months? They are the months of Rajab, the months of Dhul Qa'dah, the months of Dhul Hijjah, this current month, and the months of Al-Muharram. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a special warning against sinning during any one of the sacred months in verse number 36 of Surah At-Tawbah, Surah number 9, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when speaking on the sacred month, He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. So, do not wrong yourselves. Do not wrong yourselves by committing sins during the sacred months. So this is the first thing, that if we have to be very far away from sinning during all the year, in this sacred month of the Hijjah, and in the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah, we have to be more and more far away committing any sort of sins. Secondly, the Prophet saying that good deeds offered during the first 10 nights and days of the Hijjah are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than good deeds offered at any other time during the year. This is a general statement, which means that during the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah, it's our duty to increase our good deeds generally. It's our duty to increase good deeds of all different sorts and kinds, including fasting. It is very good that we increase our voluntary fasting during the first, actually 9 days of the Hijjah, because the 10th day of the Hijjah is the day of Al-Eid, and we are not allowed, of course, to fast on the day of Al-Eid, because we celebrate the day of Al-Eid. We are not allowed to fast the 10th day of the Hijjah. So we do our best to fast as many days as we can from the first 10 days, for the first 9 days of the Hijjah. And actually, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not abandon fasting the first 9 days of the Hijjah, except when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was ill, or when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was musafir, was on a journey. And in all other years, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would either fast all of the first 9 days of the Hijjah, or even only some of them. So it's very good that we try doing our best to fast as many days as we can from the first 9 days of the month of the Hijjah. Today is the second day of the Al-Hijjah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ما من عبد يصوم يوما في سبيل الله إلا باعد الله بذلك اليوم النار عن وجهه 70 خريفا. That whosoever fasts one day for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will keep away his face from hellfire for a distance of 70 years. So fasting, to fast and to increase our fasting is highly rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you miss fasting any of the the first 9 days of the Hijjah, so you should not miss fasting the day of Arafat, which is the 9th day of the Hijjah. So fasting on this day is even more and more blessed and more rewarded. So whosoever is able to fast, then he should not miss fasting the day of Arafah, which is the 9th day of the Hijjah, which will be, inshallah, this year, next Friday, the 8th of July. This is the day of Arafat, inshallah, and this is the 9th day of the Hijjah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept Hajj from all those who are making Hajj this year. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to make Hajj, inshallah, in the near future, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to increase our good deeds and to accept from us all. Amen. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told about the very special reward that one gets when he fasts on the day of Arafah, the 9th day of the Hijjah, by saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, صيام يوم عرفة إني أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي بعده والسنة التي قبله. Fasting on the day of Arafah, I hope from Allah that it will wipe out the sins committed for 1 year after and 1 year before. And again, this is the, inshallah, next Friday. So we do our best, inshallah, whoever is able to fast the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, which is the day of Arafah, then inshallah he should do so. Also, during these first 10 days and nights of Dhul Hijjah, we have to do our best to perfect our prayers. Brothers, they should do their best to come to perform the prayers in the masjid with the congregation as many times as they can during the day. When they do so, they even get a reward similar to this that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants to the pilgrims. Because just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Prophet Muhammad sallam told us that the accepted Hajj has no reward less than paradise, also Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, من غدا إلى المسجد أو راح أعد الله له نزلا في الجنة كلما غدا أو راح. Whosoever goes to the masjid at dawn or at dusk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepares for him a splendid house in paradise for each time or whenever he goes to the mosque and whenever he comes back from the mosque. And regarding our sisters, then they get the same reward inshallah when they perform the compulsory prayers at their appointed times at their homes. Also, another good deed that we have to stick to during, generally at all times and especially during the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah, is that we have to keep performing as Sunan al-Rawatib, which are the voluntary rak'ahs we offer before the compulsory prayers or just after the compulsory prayers. And these are 12 rak'ahs to be performed every day, 2 rak'ahs before dawn prayer, 4 rak'ahs before dhuhr prayer, and 2 rak'ahs after dhuhr prayer, and 2 rak'ahs after maghrib prayer, and 2 rak'ahs after isha prayer. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told and gave us the good news that whosoever keeps on performing these 12 sunan rawatib rak'ahs every day, he is admitted to paradise by the favor and the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, it's very good, especially during these first 10 days of the Hijjah, to keep performing Salat al-Duha. Salat al-Duha is a prayer at least 2 rak'ahs. It could be 2 rak'ahs, 4 rak'ahs, 6 rak'ahs, or 8 rak'ahs, but at least 2 rak'ahs. And its start time is 15 minutes after the sun has already risen. This is the start time of al-Duha. And its end time is also about 15 minutes before dhuhr time. So during this period of time, you can offer 2 rak'ahs at least for duha. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu said, أوصاني خليلي بثلاث صيامي ثلاثة أيام من كل شهر. هي ثلاث أيام البيض، اليوم الثالث عشر والرابع عشر والخامس عشر من كل شهر عربي، وركعتي الضحى وأن أوتر قبل أن أنام. سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه said, my intimate friend, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, advised me to keep on performing and doing 3 things. To fast 3 days from every lunar month. And these are the days number 13, 14, and 15 of every lunar month. This is the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to offer 2 rak'ahs for duha on a daily basis. And to offer salat al-watr before I go to bed. So it's very good that we keep on performing Salat al-Duha during these first 10 days of the Al-Hijjah. Also, it's very good that we increase our Qiyamul Layl during the first 10 nights of the Al-Hijjah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told, يَنْزِلُ رَبُّنَا تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ حِينَ يَبْقَى ثُلُثُ اللَّيْلِ الْآخِرِ. فيقول: من يدعوني فأستجيب له، من يسألني فأعطيه، من يستغفرني فأغفر له. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم taught, our Lord, blessed and exalted is He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, descends to the lowest heaven every night when the last third of the night is left. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, who is going to call upon me so that I respond to his call and I respond to his invocation? Who is going to ask me for a need or for his needs so that I am going to give him what he asks for? And who is going to ask me for forgiveness so that I forgive him? And this happens every night. So we should increase our qiyam al-layl, and also we should increase our dua. In the Noble Quran, all of us know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And your Lord says, call upon me and I will definitely respond to your invocation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us that He's going to respond to our invocation. So we have to, to do our best to do as many dua, inshallah, with our hearts attentive and feeling humbleness before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially during the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah. Also, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا تعجزوا في الدعاء فإنه لن يهلك مع الدعاء أحد. Don't be helpless with dua. For whosoever sticks to making dua, he will never be ruined. He will never be harmed. He will never having problems or calamities and finding no way out from them. So we have to increase our dua during these first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah, and we have to increase our istighfar as well during these first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah, and we have to make tawbah during these very blessed days and nights of the Hijjah. Regardless of whatever our sins are, or how big they are, or how many they are, we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, and we have to have the good hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving us. And you know the hadith that when the shaitan spoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and told him, وَعِزَّتُكَ وَجَلَالُكَ لَا أَزَالُ أُغْوِي بَنِي آدَمْ مَا دَامَتْ أَرْوَاحُهُمْ فِي أَجْسَادِهِمْ. فقال الله عز وجل: وعزتي وجلالي لا أزال أغفر لهم ما داموا يستغفرونني. When the shaitan, the devil, the satan, said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by your majesty and glory, I will continue deviating the sons of Adam, the children of Adam, so long as they are still alive, so long as their souls are still in their bodies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered him, by my majesty and glory, I will continue forgiving them so long as they ask me for forgiveness. So it's our role to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. If we do so, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala definitely will forgive us, especially when we do so during these very blessed 10 days and nights of the Hijjah. Of course, we have to increase our recitation from the Noble Quran. We have to increase dhikr and nazkur Allah Azza wa Jalla. We have to increase our mentioning of the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. It was narrated that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَأَكْسِرُوا فِيهِنَّ مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّحْمِيدِ والتكبير. So do as many times as you can of tahleel, saying la ilaha illallah, tahmeed, saying alhamdulillah, takbir, saying Allahu Akbar. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, afdalul kalami ila Allah arba, subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, la yadurruka bi ayyihinna badat. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, The best words in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. And it doesn't matter with which one you start. So you can start with la ilaha illallah, start with Allahu Akbar, start with alhamdulillah. And it was the practice of Sayyidina Abu Huraira and Sayyidina Ibn Umar during the first 10 days of the Hijjah that they would go to the markets and make takbir, and so other Muslims would repeat after them making takbir. So alhamdulillah, dhikrullah, saying subhanallah or alhamdulillah quietly is very easy at all places and at all times. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us all. Amen. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد. Of course a Muslim must be dutiful to his parents at all his times and must connect ties of his kinship at all his times, but especially we have to be very careful and have to do this especially with special care during the first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah. We have to have good relations with everybody. We have to end all of our disputes, of our past disputes, and we have not to dispute with anybody at all. And we have to stick to the high moral principles and to treat all people accordingly. And actually Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said inna min ahabbikum ilayya wa aqrabikum minni majlisan yawm al-qiyamah ahasinukum akhlaqa. The dearest and nearest to me on the day of judgment among you will be those of the best manners. Also it's a good idea that we increase giving charities during these first 10 days and nights of the Hajjah or the Hijjah, and bearing in mind that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said was-sadaqatu tudfi'u al-khati'a kama yudfi'u al-ma'u an-nar, and giving charities extinguishes sins just like water extinguishes fire. So the more you give charities inshallah the more you will be granted Allah's forgiveness inshallah. Also it's very good that we arrange for our qurbani, offering the sacrificial animal. Of course offering the sacrificial animal or slaughtering the sacrificial animal is to be actually done after Salat al-Eid on the first day of Al-Adha, but you can pay for it from now and you can arrange for it from now, of course. And actually offering a sacrificial animal is the practice and the way of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam and our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that whosoever follows it, whosoever follows this way of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam and our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, acquires more and more righteousness, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the noble Quran, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. Neither their meat nor their blood reaches Allah, but it is your righteousness that reaches Allah. So you know, all these rituals are meant for attaining piety. Even when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks on Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the midst of verses speaking on Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى, and seek provision, for the best provision is taqwa, is righteousness. And when we increase our good deeds, all these different and other different kinds of good deeds during these first 10 days and nights of the Hajj or the Hijjah, we are really trying to acquire piety and righteousness. So when we make dhikr Allah, or when we perform the prayers, all these acts should be done not only by the tongue, but by the heart and by the tongue, feeling submissiveness before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and humbleness before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that our hearts are more and more purified insha'Allah, and so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with us all insha'Allah. And of course, during these very blessed first 10 days and nights of the Hijjah, when we make dua, we don't make dua only for ourselves, but make dua for yourself, make dua for your relatives, make dua for your friends, for your neighbors, make dua for all people, and make dua for Muslims who are suffering at some parts of the world, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove their suffering, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects them against all harms. And make dua for all people all over the world, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them all good things and remove from them all evil things. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، وعافنا فيمن عافيت، وتولنا فيمن توليت، وبارك اللهم لنا فيما أعطيت، وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت، فإنك سبحانك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك. اللهم نسألك رضاك والجنة، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. اللهم نسألك من كل خير سألك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من كل شر استعاذك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم يسر الحج لحجاج بيت الله الحرام هذا العام، وتقبله منهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اكتب لنا جميعا الحج أعواما مديدة وأزمنة عديدة يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين، وأعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا. اللهم احفظ المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم احفظ المسلمين في بنغلاديش. اللهم احفظ المسلمين في أفغانستان. اللهم احفظ المسلمين في الهند. اللهم احفظ المسلمين في باكستان وفي كشمير وفي بورما. اللهم احفظ المسلمين في سوريا وفي العراق وفي ليبيا وفي اليمن وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظهم من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم، وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم ومن فوقهم، ونعوذ بعظمتك أن نغتال من تحتنا. اللهم احفظنا واحفظ أزواجنا وأبناءنا وبناتنا في هذه البلاد يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا، وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم ارحم أمواتنا أجمعين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى، وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي، يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليماً.